playing with you niggas at all. My classmates, they went on to be chartered accounts. Or work with their parents. But thinking back on how they treated me, my high school reunion might be worth in the Paris. Make everybody have to go through security clearance. Tables turn, bridges burn, you never learn. With the ink, I can murder word of my nigga Irv. Yeah, I swear shit just started clicking, dog. You know it's real when you are who you think you are.
Is that when it's real? When you are who, wait, you think you are, who they think you are. I was a little unclear on that. I don't need clarification. Success in accomplishing any to-dos in a while. And so I don't like making to-do lists because, you know, I don't like to not keep my word to myself. Or to anyone else for that matter, but myself especially. One of them was to contact Fiverr. My last experience was ridiculous. It was short. It wasn't, like, harmful, but it was a classic thing that would, like, only happen to me, I feel like. I was looking for someone to help me finish my website that's been going on for all eternity. And I was finally like, just okay, maybe we'll just do what everybody says and hire somebody and get it done. And I wrote to a person after reading reviews and things. And I gave him my store, you know, website address and all the things he wanted. And, the person wrote back, I mean, I just said hi, you know, like, introduction, like, I'm hiring someone, right? What do you write? You write, hey, I need someone to finish my website, you know, let's see if we can make this work, okay, whatever. So he looks at my website and he writes me back and he goes, I don't understand your concept at all. It's like, you have this really huge design, this huge logo. And, I mean, none of it makes any sense. Why? I think you need to make it very simple, much more simple and user-friendly. Okay, that's what he said to me. Without even really a greeting, like a hello or anything back. And I was just like, of course, you know, one more person that totally doesn't understand anything that I'm saying. that's the person I pick out on Fiverr. And so I wrote to him, why would you have any idea what my concept is? I never explained it to you. You know what I did? I wrote you an introductory hello email. You have no idea what my concept is. I don't expect you to. I'm an abstract artist. You know? Oh. This has been a profound period of not feeling understood at all. Like, when I say that, I mean, not just like, you know, not understood. I don't know, like my choices or, you know, whatever, but I mean, like, really, like, even on a fundamental, like language, like I don't know if I'm speaking a language that other humans understand, you know, at this point, that's where we've come to. My friends, everyone, you know, to the point of just like utter, I mean, I'm baffled. I don't know what's happened, what's changed. I mean, everything's changed, you know. And I vacillate between this feeling of, I know what I'm talking about. And I know, I mean, for lack of a better word, like, that I'm right about what I'm thinking. You know, this next moment of life is going to be about, you know, for me or whatever. Or just the process of figuring that out, because I don't actually know what the result is going to be. I don't think I'm crazy is the thing. I mean, I am, but in the right kind of way. And I've told a million people this, and again, I just feel like either people literally don't understand the words, they don't care enough to listen to them and digest them, okay? Focus, think about what I'm saying. Yeah, I guess it's those two options, but I feel like whatever kind of creativity or something that I've got, whatever it is, the intangible thing that I've tried to monetize, that I did get lucky and be able to monetize for a while, but whatever quality it is that people find to be a draw, you know, because it's not always a positive draw, it's not always a negative draw, it's literally just like, you know, just I feel like, and this is not an ego-based statement, because I quite frankly wish it wasn't like this, but there's something about the way I am in the world that is fascinating to people, whether it's in a car crash kind of way, or whether it's in a inspired kind of, you know, way, or a love kind of way, or just confused. You know, one of those feelings seems to be what I conjure in people, and to the point of like that they can't, you know, I've had an Instagram, you know, comments from strangers. You know, just saying, like, I don't know what is going on over there, but I can't stop looking, and, you know, just, you know, it's, again, you can hear it however you want. It's not, this is not coming from, like, me talking about how great I am, because that's the opposite, actually, of what I'm saying. But, you're going to be famous, you're going to be my whole life, you know? I don't want to be famous, first of all. I've never wanted to be famous. But whatever that thing is that makes people say those things to me, strangers and whatnot, you know, having just like some of, you know, designs that are worth copying, they weren't brilliant, okay? I'm half the time ashamed of some of them, because they're just, people liked them, I kept making them, you know? It's like, it's not like it's my life's work or anything, you know? But multiple things like, you know, that, I just have this feeling of like there's something, some kind of giftedness. But what it's boiled down to now is that we have, no, it's unexplainable, and it's just like me. But there's not a specific thing you can call it. It's not a specific talent or skill or whatever. And I'm perfectly thrilled with the idea of it not being something that's monetized, you know? I don't care or have to have it that way, you know? I don't have to have a career that's like, oh my god, I'm like so special and I'm like meant to do. It's like, you know, I have to be, you know, famous or successful or whatever, because I would like to have passion, you know, again for what I'm doing, and to feel like I have some purpose instead of just feeling like completely confused all the time and like a total alien weirdo. And I've said this, well, to myself, but that I think in the past, perhaps no one has ever understood what the fuck it is I'm talking about. Literally words at all. Like, they just, like, don't know, but, or, like, where I'm coming from or, like, my ideas and stuff. But that because I happen to have, like, some kind of outward success going on and people like me and I was doing fun things, that it was easy to go, like, meh, maybe I don't need to know. Well, maybe I don't need to understand a damn word she says. Like, why, you know, it's fine. Who cares? She seems to be doing all right. She seems like she's got her shit together. That sounds pretty cool. So that's one option of how things may have literally been this whole time. And now I don't have those things, you know. I don't have any, anything going on, nothing. I've been totally sad and depressed, which, you know, everybody hates, although I know it's also just like a metamorphosis, you know, and there's really no way to avoid having an uncomfortable, not fun, pretty metamorphosis, you know. It's like I can tell, you know, my dad, I mean, he's never been, you know, poor him, cursed with my sister, my mom, and I, like, the three most dramatic fucking people in the world. Well, not my sister dramatic, but, like, lifestyle choice-wise, you know, we've put him through the ringer. But he's just a non. He doesn't want to be complicated. He wants nothing to be complicated. And, you know, I mean, poor Mikers, you know, too. It's the same. And I do it. I feel very bad and guilty for people that have to deal with it. But on the other hand, it's a midlife renaissance is what I'm calling it, you know. It's not really a crisis. It's definitely not a crisis. First of all, it may be multiple, but it's not a crisis. And it's an existential issue, you know? Like, psychologically, your brain shifts into a different gear at a certain age because you, whether you are conscious of it or not, I am very conscious of it. I know that I am, like, about halfway through the amount of time I'm going to be alive this lifetime. That is a fact. That's not negative. Everyone seems to take all of these things as, like, some kind of, like, depressing negative talk, you know? And it's like, no, that's actually the truth. Notably different, you know? I mean, on my decade birthdays, I've always had a really strong feeling. You know, and they've been great. They're always great. I have nothing against aging. It's not just this magical, you know, youth. I mean, it's that I long for, but, you know, when I turned 40, I was doing really great. It was a really great, beautiful moment in my life. But I knew right then, I could see off in the distance, but I could see for the first time in my life, the finish line. The finish line that you've been told is there, that you've technically maybe seen your grandmother, or, you know, I haven't lost anybody, so I haven't really, I mean, besides Carlos, he was my first, you know. I never saw the finish line before. I heard tale. I never saw it with my own eyes. Big difference. So, this has been, you know, the most, like, I mean, by far excruciating, brutal, painful suffering I've ever experienced, you know. To be sober and then to just have a compounded, complex group of life transitions and you know, fall on me, like the Acme Safe, I always say, like the Acme Safe. I'm sure it's happening to other people, you know, it's not just me being special over here, but it's existential for everyone, and then there's just all these little contributing factors to feeling like I'm not the same person. Part of me feels like I'm getting back to this other true part of myself that I've been since I was young, you know, and which is unfortunately a very deep thinking, very philosophical, very, like, literally I want to talk about the deepest, you know, concepts and then ask really insane questions and just sit and talk about it with people forever. And that's not really something that I, in the group of people in the world that I know, is really, like, cool. And I was like this when I was young, you know? I remember being 14 and just, it's like, I just wanted to shake it off. Like, don't be like that, you know? Don't, why do you always have to be thinking so far beyond that, you know? And asking those kinds of questions. And it's like, you know, I can't lie. It's not like, and don't take this wrong, it's not like I don't absolutely love rap music and strippers in true, genuine way. I do, absolutely, 100%, wholeheartedly. However, I have to say that, you know, during that, I always say, you know, dancing changed my life at 29. Well, that's pretty much when, you know, strippers and I left the hard drug moment away behind. I was escaping that, and it was the perfect place to run to because, you know, it was all just fun. And for the first time ever, it was just like, that's what it was. It was the escape from that, having to think about all that shit all the time. You know, there's nothing more shallow when you need it to be. You know, I'm not saying all, it's like rap is shallow or strippers are shallow. It's not like that. I mean, but it's like, but it can be, you know, if you need it to be. And I needed it to be. Looking like a piece of candy, just being fucked up and partying and, you know, it was just perfect. Well, guess what? It's, you know, that's over and this is back. You know, that's how it feels. It feels like that's it and I'm back, except this time I'm old. And I know things, and I know things that are true about myself. But they sound crazy to everyone else, you know? You're lucky if you get anyone that understands or agrees, or not only that, you know, very few are even willing to, like, look and listen and be like, okay, you sound totally nuts, but okay. You know, a few relate, thank God, for the internet in this instance, or I wouldn't even feel like I had any support in regards to these sorts of things. Thank God for history, because I can see myself in lots of places in history when perhaps someone with my personality or whatever was more suited to be in, you know? But I don't wish to be back in the past. I'm happy to be where I'm at. I'm trying to, you know, my therapist told me I was about to hatch. And then he died. Which is, you know, it's very painful, and that happened. And it's also just like, I want to say ironic, I want to laugh, I want to be like, are you fucking kidding me? And he wasn't just a therapist, he was like the only person ever that is like, without pathologizing it, but like, understood what I'm talking about when I'm saying that I don't feel like anyone understands what I'm saying, or, but that on the inside, I think they're true, but the longer and longer I'm isolated and away from it, you know, anyone understanding why I am this way or wanting to talk about the deep things with me. Everyone just wants to be, you just gotta get out of your house, you just gotta, you know, go try something different, do something, go exercise. And I'm not saying exercise and certain, you know, changes besides just staying at home a lot aren't positive ones and wouldn't help, but I also know in my heart and soul that I'm a person who needs to conserve their energy, and that being in the world depletes me, and I'm unable to even give anything back. And I know that I have something to give back. And I've been in such a deep quagmire that it's like I'm just, you know, getting my head above water from all of that. And I can't go do phony things. It's just that simple. Nothing has changed in my life. I cannot go and just do phony things, you know. Phony hangouts and just go and just do this thing and it'll, you know, faking it until you make it doesn't really always work. I have left the house. I do leave the house, you know, but there's something else going on. It would be lovely to feel like somebody understood and that they could see me for what I am. And this is the craziest part. I feel like I wish that I had a very small group of people, three, a random number, who knew what I was, valued it, and knew that it was part of their job in life to protect me so that I can not feel crazy, not waste time and energy feeling crazy, not waste time listening to people tell me to go do things that I know are not the answer. Because if I felt safe and trusted and not crazy, and I did have help, like, and this is crazy, people to do some things for me, my energy can't go in all the places. It can't set up a Facebook shop and do 10,000 things and then really get the pure product, whatever it is that I have inside that is supposed to come out. I can't do all the other things and have this thing and caretake this thing and let this thing come out. And that is like a lot to ask in this world. You know how uncomfortable that is to even say that? It sounds ridiculous. It sounds like that will never happen. You don't dare ask for that. That doesn't happen, you know? And it doesn't, you know, it doesn't. Or it's like, I don't know if it's just like, you know, it's not just like financial support. Someone's supporting me, you know? It's literally like, I think I have a gift, a thing I have to give the world, or myself, or just a few people. I don't know. There's a lot of evidence leading to the fact that, you know, not to say my thing is any more special than anyone else's. I'm not implying this. I'm telling you what it feels like and what I've thought multiple times in my life. Just like, I wish that, yeah, I had this protection, I guess, the safety, this trust, and that they could have someone, whatever, this trust, this community would help, like, me take care of some menial things that are important. And I'm a part of it too. Don't want to fuck off my responsibilities in life, you know? But I don't know. It's a really weird moment on top of 10,000 weird moments that I've had just in the last year, not to mention the last three. And yeah, something's going on. John said I'm about to hatch. And then he died. But I trust him. I think he's right.